In this episode, I'm answering 5 questions on cognitive flexibility. What is it? What's a way of measuring cognitive flexibility? Are there neuropsychiatric disorders which negatively influence your cognitive flexibility? And does cognitive flexibility strengthen with age? And what's the link between video gaming and cognitive flexibility? Let's get to it. 1. What is cognitive flexibility? Cognitive flexibility refers to the brain's ability to transition from thinking about one concept to another. The quicker you're able to switch your thinking from one dimension, for instance, the color of an object, to another, let's say the shape of an object, the greater your level of cognitive flexibility. As an example, let's say you were playing a game of Texas Hold'em poker, but the dealer tells everyone that every other hand, you'll be playing 7-card stud. Mentally, you'll need a transition between the rules for Texas Hold'em and 7-card stud. Certain individuals would struggle to rapidly transition between these two card game constructs due to the fact that they have poor cognitive flexibility. They are poor at adapting to the introduction of novel stimuli and can't shift their thinking to accommodate various changes. Those who are easily able to alternate between playing Texas Hold'em and 7-card stud in an every other hand format likely have significant cognitive flexibility. Cognitive flexibility is also the ability to adjust one's thinking from old situations to new situations, as well as the ability to overcome responses or thinking which have become habitual and adapt to new situations. As such, if you're able to overcome previously held beliefs or habits because it's required for a new situation, then you'd be considered cognitively flexible. Finally, if you have cognitive flexibility, you can think about a situation from different perspectives at once. You can look at 2 aspects of a specific object and are able to see many aspects of a complex situation. 2. What's a way of measuring cognitive flexibility?
You can measure cognitive flexibility in a lot of ways.
One way of measuring it is by doing the dimensional change card sorting task. Here, children are initially asked to sort cards by a single dimension, such as color, and are then required to alter their strategy to sort cards based on a second dimension, such as shape. Typically, 3-year-old children are able to sort cards based on a single dimension, but are unable to switch to sort the cards based on a second dimension.
However, 5-year-old children are able to sort cards based on one dimension and can then switch to sorting cards based on a second dimension.
3. Are there neuropsychiatric disorders which negatively influence your cognitive flexibility?
Yes, unfortunately there are. Diminished cognitive flexibility has been noted in a variety of neuropsychiatric disorders, such as anorexia nervosa, obsessive-compulsive disorder, schizophrenia, autism, and in a subset of people with ADHD. Each of these disorders exhibit varying aspects of cognitive inflexibility.
For example, for those with OCD, it's hard to shift their attentional focus and inhibit their motor responses. 4. Does cognitive flexibility increase with age?
No, alas, it doesn't.
The elderly often experience deficits in cognitive flexibility. The aging brain undergoes physical and functional changes, including a decline in processing speed, central sensory functioning, white matter integrity, and brain volume.
However, studies suggest that aerobic exercise and training can have plasticity-inducing effects, which could potentially serve as an intervention which combats this decline in these cognitive abilities.
5. What does video gaming have to do with cognitive flexibility? Dutch researchers have conducted studies on cognitive flexibility and video games. They observed that players of first-person shooter games such as Call of Duty or Battlefield exhibited greater cognitive flexibility on a series of measures than did non-gamers.
The researchers posit that while video gameplay may be controversial due to frequently graphic content, harnessing the effect of such games could lead to similar gains in various populations. What they are saying is, let the elderly and people with certain neuropsychiatric disorders play video games such as Call of Duty, and they will strengthen their cognitive flexibility. This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be back with a new video in my IQ series. Till then, I only want to say three things. Thank you for watching. Have a great day, and bye, y'all.